Hey guys, so today I wanted to do a quick video of my new to me Z4, showing you around what's happened to it since you've last seen it, probably on somebody else's channel, and yeah, have a walk and a talk. So actually, you eagle-eyed viewers among you might recognise this and also the location, as I've kindly aptly chosen it for it, but it is actually the Z4 that belonged to its Joel. I bought it from him in September 2021, and it's absolutely been brilliant since. So as you may be aware, it was on eBay and then the eBay sale fell through, so I actually just reached out to him via Instagram and yeah, was able to buy the car from him. As you can see, it's got my new plate on it, so my first initial birth year and then surname as well, which pretty vain, but I think it really fits me and the car quite nicely. It still has the custom painted alloys which he did on them. This was the original wheels, I believe, and then he got them painted in this, I would say, brilliant colour, but they are currently part mud. Yeah, I've got to be honest, but they do come up really nicely. Don't worry, I've taken really good care of them, so no scratches there. Aerial is still broken, but I think it was kind of fitting to keep that as well. And then down here as well, we still have the exhaust, so it's still got the back box missing from it, but this is actually a new exhaust on it. So from where the back box was to the exhaust tips here had actually rotted away from where in his video he had got the back box delete, but yeah, it kind of was not the best for emissions that way, but it was absolutely sounding mega. It still sounds brilliant now, but at the moment, as you can see, I've kind of customized it with I would say mud, probably going to some spirited traction control off driving. So she is starting to show her age with a cataract, as you could say on it, and then evidence of a disc for taking it to Europe, which I've actually done twice with it now. It's still got the black kidney grills that were installed by Joel, and then yeah, except it's like some of the age-related marks along here. It's still in really good shape. Really happy with it. It still drives amazingly. Currently at the moment, I'm actually looking to take this to Monaco. So looking to drive through the south of France, all the way to Monaco, up through Switzerland as well, and then loop via Belgium. And then of course, with a car this age, the key doesn't work on electrics, so I can't do anything remote, which is a slight inconvenience, as you would probably expect from a 18-year-old car. Now, I got this working, so the bonnet release works first time now. You'll be glad to hear. But yeah, 3 litres of BMW power there. I think it might still have a slight oil leak. So when Joel sold it, it was listed as having an oil leak. That was diagnosed as a rocker cover gasket, so I've had that replaced. Also, when I bought it, the rear tires were not in the best shape, but being a rear-wheel drive fun car to have, I don't blame anyone at all for enjoying that. Honestly, taking off the traction control and letting the rear have some fun is absolute blast in this. So other than that, it's going really smoothly with the car. With a car this old, you do expect some problems though. So you can't really see too much into here, but there might still be some oil coming out around here, but I'm gonna have to get that diagnosed again. And then also I'm getting a coolant light, or maybe oil light, coming up on the dashboard. But this is now hot. This was running cold after having some coolant added, which means that the coolant wasn't circulating correctly. So I managed to get that fixed, but I don't think the coolant has been totally bled correctly, so it's actually booked into the RBM Hampshire actually, to get that assessed. I don't want to do 3,000 miles in it and not have it reliable in a week. But yeah, absolute brilliant car. Let's give you a quick show of its sound. Hopefully, as you can see in here, she's going quite healthy. So I'm going to take it in, get the fluids had a look at, and see if we can get that diagnosed correctly. And then she's more or less good to go. So I thought, yeah, today I thought I'd introduce this car to my channel now and see where we go from here. I'd like to learn more about mechanics as well with this car, and absolutely brilliant car to keep alive and keep on the road, as they're not really the most common sight, but I think it's one of those things where you get one, or you become made aware of them, and you see them everywhere now. So I just see Z4 after Z4 after Z4, and it always puts a smile on my face. I get a few nice comments about the exhaust note as well, compared to the stock exhaust, as it is quite calm, I feel, the stock exhaust note compared to this one now. But it's kind of one of those things of just like, if you have it, you gotta show it off, which is absolutely a brilliant way of thinking about it. Hope you enjoyed the quick overview of the car. But yeah, feel free to like and subscribe. Drop a comment down below if you have any ideas of what you think I should do with this car. Currently, as I said, I've got the road trip planned down to Monaco, and then maybe actually fix it as well myself, as the dash having lights on it is never a good sign at all. Hope you enjoyed this quick video, and I'll catch you next time.